Folks have reviewed it and said that the film is essentially not good.
I would give it like a light 7 out of 10. I think it was a wonderful attempt. It looks good. I mean, for this orc, he's basically the Jackie Robinson of orcs. You know, he goes into the LAPD. The LAPD is still corrupt. LAPD is still racist. But in this world, you have elves, humans, and orcs. Orcs are black people. Humans are white people, and elves are Jewish people. The ogre literally says, how come everywhere I go, the orcs are seen as the bad guys? Will Smith, in the beginning of the film, tells his daughter, every race is equal, treat everybody equal. When the orc knocks on his door, he's like, why are you over here? Why are you in my neighborhood? Why are you on my lawn? Get off my lawn. I just don't think they don't go that deep into it. It becomes more of just like a big blockbuster, expensive action film, and kind of the racial undertones, the larger message kind of gets lost in all of the explosions and all of the magic. There are like two or three big scenes. Again, there's another scene in the beginning when they're on patrol. You see the LAPD beating up a group of orcs, like young orcs. Mm-hmm. And then Will Smith, when they pull over, Will Smith is like, so I need to know, when we out here in the field, are you an orc or are you a cop? Do I have to watch out for you too? Or are you gonna choose your race over me? Basically is what he's saying. So you're like, is that the conversations that black cops have in the patrol car? Are you gonna choose your race over the badge? So it's kind of a really interesting dynamic.
Chance the Rapper went on to say, wondering how you guys are feeling about the lynched orc in the Bright, hashtag Bright movie. I found the way they tried to illustrate America's racism through the mythical creatures to be a little shallow.
Racism between human beings, our actual racism, takes a back seat to the hate of a creature that doesn't even exist. So I understand if he feels cheated, or if the experience feels cheapened, that it has to be told in such a manner. So they're using this alternate reality as a vehicle to really get out a powerful message. As you know, if we just come out and say what's on our mind, people reject it. They say that we are complaining. They say, oh, we're using racism as an excuse, capitalism as an excuse, slavery as an excuse. So you have to give it to people in an easier format. They even did that with the film Avatar. Yep. Where that's literally the story of
a billion-dollar situation.
Story of colonialism, right. Story of the genocide of the Native American, it's the story of the rape of Africa. So I mean, it's so many things going on in that film.
What are your thoughts about this? A mental disorder if you post too many selfies. All right, so they define it as what? The quote, the obsessive compulsive desire to take photos of oneself and post them on social media as a way to make up for the lack of self-esteem and to fill a gap in intimacy. And it has categorized it into three levels: borderline, acute, and chronic self-fight. They use the measurement, Travis, if you're taking up to 3 selfies in a day. Like, that's a problem.
Well, I mean, a lot of these young ladies out here gotta be put on notice, man. They be doing like 100 picture photo shoots and choose 3. You know what I mean? Oh, that's not perfect enough. You know, I honestly think it's depression. You know, I've actually read an article when they say if you post too much and you take pictures of yourself too much and you post them, you're looking for public approval. You're looking for love outside oneself, and that can become very dangerous. I've actually seen people post selfies of themselves and it didn't get enough likes. They delete it and retake the selfie in hopes that it will get more likes. You know what I mean? So I think it's kind of a weird spectrum of, on the one end you got depression, and on the other end you have narcissism, where a person may think everything that they say, everything that they post, every selfie is just gonna be the cure for cancer. You know what I mean? And they put it out there, like, this is helping you, not me, you know?
If there wasn't any cultural backlash, people would take a selfie at a funeral.
There have been times where I've actually seen ussies where the grandparent has just died. The grandmother just took her last breath. Somebody like this in the air with a cell phone. Oh, me and my dead granny. Hey, say hello. She just passed away. Body not even cold.
Travis Case, thank you so much. Our film critic here for the culture, man. We appreciate you.
Thank you, sir. It's a blessing. Always a blessing.
Absolutely.